that people can see.
You see, the party I formerly belonged to, the National Democratic Party, you know, believe so much in
Are you still the acting chairman?
I was the acting national chairman. You know, we believe so much in generational leadership change. And while we were driving that, we discovered that there was no way you could run away from tapping from the knowledge, the wisdom, the experience of the older generation. There is no way you can run political parties without having those individuals who have seen it all, who can tell you we made mistakes here while we're growing up. We don't expect you to make similar mistakes. It has to be a conscious evolutionary process of transferring leadership from the older generation of Nigerians to the younger generation of Nigerians, so that in the final analysis, there will be, you know, unanimity in pursuing the goals and aspirations of your party, but in the larger context of the country. You see, people tend to, you know, run away or make mistakes of saying that a particular party is parading on manners of person very old and all that. There's no way you can run away from that, particularly in power equation. You must tap experiences from people. There are some states or some parties that are being run by young men. I've seen quite a number of persons you brought here who, you know, who are leaders of their political parties, very mushroom parties and what have you. What difference have they made? What have they shown any difference from what we are complaining about? Have they shown experience? Have they shown class in this, you know, 21st century age? I said no. Everybody is just grabbling for materialism and what have you. They don't seem to, you know, understand that you have to build parties based on your ideology.
Are you also saying that you have no faith in the youth?
Youth?
Yeah.
To a large extent, I have faith in the youth. But there has to be a conscious reorientation and attitudinal change in the way and manner that the minds of the youth work these days. Because if you go out on the street and you want to recruit even a young mind, you discover that the quality of what you get is something to worry about. And that also has so much to talk about our educational system. And for 2 months now, 1.5 months, the ASUU has been on strike. And you expect that when they are on strike, these youths will be languishing somewhere, and at the end of the day, they will still go back to that same school, and when they finish, they will say they are graduates. But call an average Nigerian graduate and tell him or her to do a letter to an agency or organization on your behalf. If it's going to be 3 paragraphs, you are going to correct as many sentences as possible. I've seen it, I've experienced it, because I also recruit, I also employ people. I have about 14 persons under my employ.
They largely blame the leaders, because it's what society has forced on them.
Let me say, it's a two-way traffic. The leadership has a role. The followership also has a role. You don't just put every blame right on the doorsteps of the leaders alone. The followership, even the average mind, the youths that we're talking about, how much time do they have to even go into the libraries and pick books and read? Everybody is talking about cyber intelligence. Everybody want to Google and you want to easy way to get at it. No. There are some residual knowledge that you can find in books on the shelves that you can't get on the internet. People don't do that any longer. You tell them to write long essay or thesis, what you get is opposite of what the issues are.